biggest gathering of the Philippines' top public relations and communications professional is happening next month at the Fairmont Hotel in Makati City.
And here to tell us more about the 30th National PR Congress is the event's chairperson, Lady Ochelle Espinosa. Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon to this is Roadshow. Hello, Stanley.
It's good to have you here. Now, you're having the 30th National Public Relations Congress very soon. Can you tell us about this event first?
All right. So the 30th National Public Relations Congress is happening next month, and this aims to address the challenges and transformation within the field of public relations. This year's theme is the No One. And the No One signifies its purpose as a guide or indicator reflecting the dynamic nature of the industry and the need for adaptation in the face of changing times. So as you see, our theme this year is all about time. So okay. in terms of discussion of times, it's going to be a three-portion section of the entire two-day event. So we will honor the past, we will thrive in the present, and we will prepare all the communicators for the future.
And all of that will have specific insights from very special guests or speakers that you will have on the program. Who can we expect to speak there?
Oh, definitely, Sandy. So there's going, as mentioned, there will be three parts of the two-day event that's happening at the Fairmont Makati this September 14 to 15. This year it's going to be two full days, so it will be jam-packed with different speakers from the private sector, the academe, and the government. So if allow me to give a glimpse of what the attendees will be expecting from this. So we'll be answering several questions such as, who is the PR pro? How do you begin networking? How do we craft compelling stories? How do we forge relationships with the media, our friends in the media? And then we'll also look into thriving the present, like how to build trust and restore reputation. Mm-hmm. We will also answer questions such as, are the trends still trending at this point? How do we achieve data-driven PR success? And also for the future, we're all talking about AI. And how does this hold into the profession of public relations? And of course, we end, and this is just among the many topics, but we also wanted to end the PR Congress by pushing the envelope further by institutionalizing public relations as a profession. So you will hear from speakers, as you saw on your screens earlier, from big institutions such as GCash, Globe, SM Supermalls, and you will also hear from the academe, from the ACNEO, from the University of the Philippines, and definitely from the government side of public relations and public policy making. We will have guests also from MMDA chairman, and then the different undersecretaries from different government agencies. So it's going to be an exciting two-day Congress with different kinds of topics that will definitely benefit communicators, reputation managers, and leaders and change makers in the communications field.
Lady, bringing back what you mentioned a while ago, that the theme really focuses on time, could you tell us, I guess, about the evolution of public relations and what's the current state of it right now?
So in terms of the evolution of public relations, we all want to actually go back to the basics, that in terms of just the evolution, right? We want to go back to the basics. We wanted to ask, we've gone forward with all the AI and the PR 2.0, but we want to go back to the basics. That's why there's three portions of the PR Congress. We want to challenge also how do PR professionals and communicators really have to master the influence of communication. We also want to go back to unraveling the art of media relations. And we also want to go back to the magnetic brand storytelling. Mm-hmm. And this is all about going back to basics, going back to the drawing board. But we also want to touch base further on the present. What are the points that every communicator, public relations professional should touch base in, such as managing crisis communications, fake news, and of course, definitely reputation management. Mm-hmm. We also want to unleash the importance of having a communications degree, but this time we want to push public relations as a degree in the Philippines. We also want to look into how do we win awards after crafting all these compelling stories. And we also want to look at how do we measure definitely the impact of our profession. And as we evolve further into the future, we want to ask, are we actually diverse enough in making sure that our campaigns are inclusive? We also want to look into online impact, of course, digital, social. Is it even correct to address PR as traditional and digital? Is there even a difference now? We also have guests who will join us from our cousins or our equivalents from the global PR standpoint. So we will have guests from Indonesia coming over. We will have guests from Vietnam and also Hong Kong, and definitely our counterparts in the global stage. So every PR professional ready in the local space, but also having that global PR passport is important as we move on to the future. We're talking about future here, so diversity, equity, inclusivity, and also influencers. Should we fold them in into PR strategies? All of these and more are definitely going to be part of that three-part past, present, future of our two-day event in the PR Congress this year.
Now, Leigh, they really highlighted, I guess, on the future-proofing of public relations. But I also saw how you wanted to honor the past, you know, focusing on the basics. Could you share, I guess, some key milestones in the field of PR that has shaped them to where it is now and where it is headed?
Oh, definitely. This is our 30th year of focusing on the PR Congress. And different milestones have come along the way for the Public Relations Society of the Philippines. We are at the 30th PR Congress, but we're also celebrating the 59th Angle Awards that's coming. So not just celebrating as a community, not just winning as a profession, but we also want to shape, be part of the boardrooms. We're now part of decision making. We're looking at reputation and perceptions built on how individuals and organizations or brands are looking into PR professionals as part of the decision making and strategic messaging. We've also won global awards with our local brands, and public relations professionals are definitely a part of how those stories have shaped and compelling stories have impact our audiences. We also want to touch base a little more on just shaping the perception and reputation. You know, PR is the strategic management of communication to influence and shape public perception. But we also want to emphasize that through well-crafted messaging, public relations has evolved over time to also be reputation managers and reputation leaders of individuals, organizations, and brands to be perceived very well by the public. So this year, we want to champion that. We want to champion intention to impact through public relations. As we all know that intentions only hold value when translated into tangible actions and positive impact. And I hope our audiences here this afternoon will be able to join us and celebrate that milestone, this milestone of the public relations profession with the Public Relations Society.
Yes, Lady, I'd like to go to the future now. When you talk about future public relations practitioners, the academe plays a very important role in terms of honing, in terms of the clarity that it provides its graduates. What to you are the attributes, the non-negotiable attributes of a future PR professional in this day and age?
So a PR professional must definitely hold authenticity and transparency. And these two terms have actually been, you know, thrown into different boardrooms and tables and discussions over time. But education and training for PR professionals cannot be overemphasized. That's why we in the Public Relations Society of the Philippines, as we mark our 30th year of the PR Congress, we want to end the PR Congress by pushing the envelope to institutionalize PR, as this involves creating avenues for education and professional development in the field. We want well-trained PR professionals to be equipped and uphold ethical practices and drive positive change, as not just honoring the past, being in the present, but definitely, as you said, Stanley, move forward into the future.
Now, Lady also mentioned, I guess, about embracing AI, and now from, of course, focusing on collaborations with not just people, companies, institutions, but AI as well. How does the Congress, I guess, plan to encourage PR professionals to collaborate and also share experiences, especially in a time where remote work and virtual interactions have become quite the norm?
It's good that you highlighted that, Denise, because we're also looking at internal PR. It's not necessarily usually discussed over time, but I think it's very stitched into the future of PR. So internal PR will be discussed here in the Congress, as well as you mentioned, we want to ride the wave of future trends and emerging tools. So as PR professionals, while we craft stories, we want AI and tools to be our partner, to be of good use to us. But definitely, these are going to be discussed on how artificial intelligence and automation in public relations should be used as tools. But at the end of the day, it's the human intelligence, the human creativity that should be in collaboration with what is available now for all of us as tools. We want to look into virtual and augmented reality in PR campaigns. Are there emerging technologies that will actually help further stretch the impact of public relations? Of course, there's TikTok, there's audio storytelling, there's podcasting, but we also want to touch base in that may not necessarily be talked as often as we would want it to be. We all have TikTok, Instagram Reels, the rise of short-form video. So these are all opportunities in niche platforms and emerging technologies that every public relations professional and communicator should take advantage of.
Now, a lot of exciting and even incisive coverage there, subjects to be tackled during the One PRSP. How does one get in touch with you in case they are interested to join, Lady?
Thank you for that, Stanley. So please go to our Facebook page and of the Public Relations Society of the Philippines. You will see all the details there. You can also get in touch with our secretariat at secretariat@prsp.ph. And you'll definitely look at all, you will see all the details and information on how to join us at the Public Relations Society of the Philippines 30th National PR Congress. And let's celebrate our profession and celebrate that time is definitely our ally in PR and communications.
All right, Chairperson Lady Ochelle Espinosa of the National PR Congress, we wish you well on your activity and thanks a lot for joining us this afternoon.
Thanks, Lady.
Thank you. Thank you very much for having us.